The spear was one of the oldest, most prominent weapons in history and prehistory. Its use has been dated back to at least 600,000 years ago, which means that this technology outdates even the existence of the first humans. Spears have been used for many purposes, such as warfare, fishing, and perhaps most importantly, hunting. Their use and design has evolved greatly over the past hundreds of thousands of years and has impacted our history immensely. Spears changed our history, culture, and some anthropologists claim that the invention of spears has even changed our biology also. They claim that spears used in hunting were the very reason for the increased size of the human brain. It was due to their lifestyle change, in which early humans, hominids, went from scavengers to hunter-gatherers. Before spears, a significant portion of early human diet consisted of mushrooms, berries, wild onions, roots, and a bunch of other plants that could be gathered. The other half was most likely scavenged leftovers abandoned by stronger and faster predators such as lions and hyenas. It was only with the adoption of the spear that early humans began having access to a meat-rich diet. This allowed them to maintain bigger, more powerful, but also more energy-demanding brains. Brains which are responsible for all the great things that we enjoy today. The first spears must have looked like ordinary long branches with a sharp point. A hominin wielding such a weapon was far more threatening and powerful than one which wielded a simple large stone. Especially in hunting, a spear provided piercing power absolutely unmatched by any other early human invention. Coupled with its long range, it was the perfect weapon for hunting large animals with thick hides such as deer, wild cattle, horses, and even elephants. Early humans, such as Homo erectus, were known for their incredible stamina. They, as well as any other human today, in their peak physique, could catch any animal. Sure, a horse would be able to outrun us initially, but with enough energy and tracking experience, it would be just a matter of time. But hominids, including humans, were also great thinkers. Their intelligence was simply unmatched. Hunting in groups and chasing animals into traps was part of any good hunting strategy. Energy preservation was key. In some cases, humans even burned entire forests to lure animals out into their traps. As humans drove larger animals close to extinction with the use of spears, they were forced to hunt smaller, faster prey. A far less efficient endeavor. This repeated process of hunting animals close to extinction was likely one of the primary forces in the development of more sophisticated hunting weapons. Weapons such as the stone-tipped spear, the Atlatl, as well as the bow and arrow. There were many iterations of spears in the past. One of the most prominent was the javelin. This specific iteration was significant because throwing spears have allowed humans to hunt more dangerous animals from a safer distance. Stone-tipped javelins weren't the first spears that were meant to be thrown, but they were certainly the most effective. For instance, a regular spear could be thrown, but the impact would be far too weak to be deadly. That's why the javelin came with multiple improvements over the basic spear. It was slimmer and had a sharp stone tip. It could be thrown accurately as far as 15 meters, making it the deadliest weapon of its time. But it was nothing when compared to the Atlatl. The spear-throwing lever, also known as the Atlatl, was a small wooden tool used as leverage to launch projectiles at lethal speeds. This method of throwing imparted huge amounts of force onto the spear, propelling it with deadly speed to almost twice the distance. although it's likely that they were first used in Europe around 30,000 years ago, Atlatls have been used on almost every continent around that time. Even Australian Aboriginals used an almost identical device. The spear thrower technology was revolutionary, a hunting weapon which allowed our cave-dwelling ancestors to hunt and feast on some of the largest animals such as the woolly mammoth and the woolly rhinoceros. As evident with the disappearance of many species around this period, humans thrived, explored and multiplied until they began to feel the consequences of unknowingly exhausting their primary sources of food. Some experts claim that this very phenomenon has led humans to begin agricultural lifestyles within villages and cities, still hunting within the surrounding regions but mostly switching to the domestication of plants and animals. As more and more tribes began to settle, form their own agricultural communities, fertile land became sparse and ownership disputes began to form. This, in conjunction with the luck-based nature of farming being completely dependent on favorable weather, was likely one of the primary reasons for the inception of warfare, where the next and final major iteration of spears came in. Some of the first major conflicts based around profits likely started during this agricultural period. A period in time where humans no longer had to choose wisely what they took with them as they migrated. They could instead accumulate wealth such as grains, cattle, fertile land and other resources in their villages. This in turn left a reason for desperate communities on the brink of starvation to fight, steal and eventually conquer. As technology advanced, farming became easier, the populations grew larger and the idea of conquering remained. Each village, town and city became part of something bigger, and as warfare evolved with the discovery of metals, it was spears once again that dominated. All the way up until the 14th century, it remained as one of the most prominent weapons around the globe.